Fertility rates here in the United States are at a record low, so you may be surprised to hear that more women, especially in their 40s, are now moms. The older you are, the more difficult it can be to get pregnant, and it's why, as Denver 7 anchor Molly Hendrickson shows us, more women are turning to fertility testing to help them.
It's the sound of the old proverbial clock. Our bodies telling us time is running out. And like it or not, the ticking clock is a reality women face.
My biological clock is ticking like this.
But now, advancements in science are helping more women have children at a later age. The Colorado Center for Reproductive Medicine and doctors like Eric Suri help women find out about their fertility and just how much time is left on their clocks.
This testing is really not designed for the infertile woman. They have a whole different set of tests to do and needs. This is more the woman who perhaps has delayed getting pregnant because of career or is in an early part of a relationship where she's not really sure that she's ready to get pregnant.
And research shows many women are trying to extend their clocks, putting off childbearing to advance their careers and education. According to the National Center for Health Statistics, the average age of first-time mothers in 2014 was 26.3, up from 24.9 in 2000. 86% of women ages 40 to 44 are mothers. And now through a series of tests, doctors can look at a woman's hormone levels and egg count to predict her reproductive potential.
But I always emphasize with patients that this is not completely accurate. It just gives you a sense of where you are on the spectrum.
And so at 37, we decided to test my fertility. First up, a simple consultation where Dr. Suri asked me about my reproductive history.
You've not been pregnant before.
Next, an ultrasound.
You can see these black circles here. Mm-hmm. Those are your follicles.
To count follicles, which is where eggs mature in the ovaries.
You have 10 follicles on the right side. That's a very high, healthy number.
And finally, a blood test measuring three hormone levels specifically. The follicle-stimulating hormone, or FSH, estradiol hormone, and the anti-Mullerian hormone, or AMH. Together, they work as a seesaw. But as a woman ages, so does the quality of her eggs, and those hormones begin to change too.
We actually see a significant increase in genetically abnormal embryos when women hit around 37.
The testing, originally intended to measure egg supply in women struggling to get pregnant, is now used for women who are deciding whether to freeze their eggs. But it's also been criticized as inaccurate and misleading.
We all have a different slope. We all have different rates of aging of any of our organs.
For my test, the results were back in less than a week.
Hi.
Good to see you again, Molly. Welcome back.
While they showed a healthy follicle count, they also showed a slightly higher FSH level and a slightly lower AMH level compared to other women my age.
Now that doesn't mean, again, you know, doom and gloom, but it does suggest a little bit lower fertility than, again, someone else your age.
In other words, time is not exactly on my side, and for millions of women whose clocks are also ticking, the end may not be as close as once feared. At the Colorado Center for Reproductive Medicine, Molly Hendrickson, Denver 7.
And at that Colorado Center for Reproductive Medicine, fertility testing costs $735. And the downside, in most cases, it's not covered by insurance.